not gonna do tonight. But if you're still waiting with your love so true, you'll make me. Ooh, man.
You see this young man dancing on the dance floor? That's my dad, George W. Weaver. I don't know what to say, describe how my father is. My father is multiple things. A humorous, kind-hearted, wonderful individual, very intellectual. That's my dad. I don't know what to say, but I'm very blessed to have a father like George Weaver. And five of my brothers and sisters are very fortunate to have him as their father, as well as me. And I don't know what to say. I'm out of words because my father raised all six of us. And he was a rolling stone. I give him credit for that. You know, where he lay his hat is his home. But his family values are real strong. He got real strong values and gave us work ethic for all six of us. Yes, he could be a hard ass at times. He could be a wonderful, he can be multiple things. He could be a sweetheart, you know, father that he is. Very caring, very protective.
When I was a child,
Bullhead Sims.
When I became a man,
Scotus.
When I became a man, I had to put away them child thoughts.
I knew that black Bullhead suit you had with the gates.
Yeah, man.
So, I mean, you know.
No, yeah, we all, you know, we go through faith. You got something real deep.
This cleaning everything out. This is the okay. I was just thinking.
Very protective and very knowledgeable. And he's not just knowledgeable, just all six. He's not just the intellectual. He's intellectual with everybody. He's very kind-hearted with everybody he knows. That's who he is. He don't take no shit though. I give him that. He ain't take no shit out of nobody. And he makes sure he give knowledge to those who are in need of it. He give everybody knowledge because knowledge is power, you know. My father's full of knowledge. All he do is read. And it's a beauty part because he knows a lot. And that's why he's at the age right now. Healthy as he can be. He's real wise. I could listen to my father all day. With his lectures, his crazy stories, and his journeys and throughout his lifetime. And he gave us the best years, and still is the best years of our lives, because my father is a man's man and a very sentimental, beautiful human being that I have run across. And I'm a very fortunate one, because a lot of young black men don't have fathers. Me, Sam, Georgie are a very fortunate black man to have a father. And he's a grandfather today with seven grandchildren. I'm counting. I'm the last Mohegans. Sam got his little daughter's beautiful daughter named Skylar. I'm the last Weaver to have a child, which I'm not worried yet because I ain't see the world. Marvin Gaye's track, Sexual Healing, I guess it sums it up right that me and Sam came to this world through that track. I see why. And man, it got a good reason to it. And that beat is jumping. And he did a wonderful job bringing us to this world. And I appreciate that. Including Marvin Gaye. Sensational healing. Still living life. And my dad's full of life. He just dance on the part time. We ride bikes together. We do everything together growing up. And I still do everything, even at 30 years old. Calling our sisters. Got time to spend time with my dad. Because my dad meant a lot. He meant so much. He meant so much to everybody. And I love him to death. And this is my Father's Day tribute to my dad, George Peter. Guess what? Many years to come. He said he's gonna make it to 100. I believe that. Because every moment I want to spend with my father, I try to make the most of it. My mom, too, makes the most of it. Spend time. You know, they get on each other's nerves. They still love each other. sister, Sierra. The youngest out of all Weavers.
Yes, the baby.
The baby. I'm the second baby of the family. I wonder, you know, Dad, who being the good man he is, I wonder what's your favorite moment? Any moment, like when you remember.
I had a lot of moments, but let's see. The most joyful moment I can remember where we were all together is when Daddy came to the pool hall in his new van.
Yep.
And the chairs lay down flat, and Dad was like, come on outside. So we run into the car. We're like, what? This is ours. So he let us ramshack that sucker. Like, we laid everything down. Yep. Had our feet on everything, turning lights on and off because it had, like, little light trimmings or light whatever. Trims. And we could just lay down in the back. And then we would argue, and then Daddy said, cut that mess out or whatever. Y'all better shut up or something like that or whatever. But we had a blast. Every time we came over there, it was a blast, you know. We always have our fights. Everybody had their fights. But Daddy shut everybody up and shut you down real quick, you know.
1984 was a great year. It's around Christmas time. Took me, all the cousins, sisters, visit family down there in Florida. They fed us good.
What's your memory of your dad, just be honest?
Memories of my Papa Bear is just being Papa Bear. I remember when we were younger and we had Prince, and he used to walk in. Prince was our baby. I miss him.
Yep.
When Daddy was skinny.
Yep. Yeah. Prince was something else.
I mean, Dad has always had the belly, but he was a little less belly. I remember him making us learn to read. And I appreciate that about Dad. He was an avid one for us, for our education. And that carried on with me as I became older.
Yep.
And I appreciate that for him. Sam was a big reader. He was the one who could go through a book in like 2 minutes.
You're the math genius.
Yeah, I love my math.
I hate it with passion.
Math is finite.
I know.
Yeah, you know, but I got my passion for learning from Dad. You know, he always was always open-minded to learn new and different things, even if everybody wasn't, you know, always gung-ho about it. He would still be like, he would want to learn because knowledge is power. And that, I love that about my daddy bear, Papa.
What is it?
It was a great time. Dad took us, the whole family, mostly all the kids, grandkids, and his kids, to a nice trip to Walt Disney World, SeaWorld. We went on numerous trips to Walt Disney World around my younger years. Then we started having more kids.
We started having me, Sam, and Sierra.
We never got a trip to go with all of us, but I think if we did it over again, he probably would have did it.
Yep.
Would have been nice. I mean, he was a great father. I mean, you know, you did your best at the times. Love you, Dad. Happy Father's Day.
Yes, the education part. When my brothers and sisters, we had learned to read and write and do math, which is good. But my merriest parts is the silly shit. The silly shit my dad, you know, went to and episodes. We call them episodes. Those niggerology episodes with my dad. And my favorite part is he's a humble, sweet, wonderful man that he is. He ain't gonna take no shit. By taking no shit, he made sure nobody crossed that line. That goes for everybody. Especially, he got that Jedi mind trick activated. He got a crazy-ass neighbor across the street. He talked to himself in public all the time. Which is nothing wrong with it. He's different. He's kind of loony. But we called him that Doe. That's our neighbor. We thought he was dead. And we know he was dead, so we came in. I said, Daddy, did that bill ain't moving. I think he's dead. He was off that Hennessy. Fuck you. me and dad, you motherfucking dad, you want me sleeping shit. He's letting me feel sleeping, son. Don't worry, I'll wake him up. He walked up to him, went across the alley. Wake the fuck up, nigga. Nigga got up, smiled, lift that door, smiled, said, hey, my dad hauled and slapped the shit out of this dude. Just to wake him up and thought he was dead. He said, he look at us, hey, told that nigga ain't dead. Shit, what y'all worried about? my dad's a character, man. My dad is a character to the fullest. Love my father for that, big time. And dad, you've been a wonderful father ever since. I'm no man that cannot replace a father like yourself. And I love you to death, dad. I really do. And it's a blessing to have you. And you have a wonderful Father's Day as always. Right here.